I'm going to have you go into this paragraph, and we're going to just look at the final sounds, okay? So are you looking at this TED Talk here? It says, I remember my first fire. So it'll be really nice for us to kind of practice those final sounds in this situation. Okay, so go ahead and read for me.
Yeah. I remember my first fire. I was the second volunteer on the scene. So there was a pretty good chance I was going to get in, but it still was a real foot race against the other volunteers to get to the captain in charge to find out what our assignments would be. When I found the captain, he was having a very engaging conversation with the homeowner, who was surely have one of the worst days of her life. Here is where the middle of the night. She was standing outside the pouring rain under an umbrella in her pajamas, barefoot, while her house was in flames.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Good job. So here's what I'm seeing is that the first step, and let me kind of show you the progression of what's going to happen. So the first step is getting aware of those ending sounds and saying, oh, I tend to drop those. Now I need to focus on getting them in place. Okay. So what we're going
what
to do.
That's what I'm doing now. I'm sorry, but that I'm doing because long time I try. It's become my habit. I had no final sound. When I get back with the final sound, I'm kind of struggling.
Okay, so let me explain to you kind of what the progression will be from here. So you have that awareness now, and so you're really working hard on getting those ending sounds. What happens is then you become really focused on the ending sounds, and it's hard to kind of smoothly connect from word to word, right?
Yeah,
so, exactly. But that's okay. That's where I want you to be right now, because unless we break that habit of dropping the ending and we just jump to fluent moving from one to word, one word to the next, you're going to continue to drop sounds. Okay, so we have to be at this level of just getting the ending sounds, even if it doesn't sound as fluent and as fluid, from one word to next, we have to just practice getting that ending sound in place so your mouth gets used to that. Okay?
Yeah.
So that's step one, and that's what you're doing right now, and I love what you're doing right now. Okay.
Oh, thank you.
So it's really, really good for you to just keep practicing getting those ending sounds. The next step will be to link and connect from word to word. So things like this, you might have to find out, you might kind of have it be a little bit more broken up, but you're still getting that ending sound, and that's where I want you to be. The next step is going to be saying, okay, now I'm going to get the ending sound, but then I'm also going to connect it. So what that looks like is to say, go slowly and go to find out. So do that for me. To find out.
To find out.
Mm-hmm. Find out. So we're going to still get that N in there. Find out.
To find out.
Mm-hmm. So find out, having one, and we're going to kind of put that in the back of our throat, having one. Good, very good. Here it was. Good. So we're still putting our tongue in the place of the T sound, but we're not necessarily releasing it. Here it was. Mm-hmm. Okay. Was having. Good. Was going. Good. Okay. So the next step, because you're getting your ending sounds on, you're really practicing that. The next step is then to say, okay, I'm going to start practicing just kind of linking and connecting. So instead of I remember my first fire, where you're really deliberate about getting those ending sounds, then we're going to start saying, I remember my, so we're keeping the voice on, I remember my first fire. So we're kind of keeping that flow going. I remember my first fire. Do that for
I
me.
I remember my first fire.
Good, very nice. So that's kind of the next step, is we're going to start kind of just smoothing it out and connecting it together. And then as that gets better, then we can kind of move on to getting, you know, the different intonation and make it sound a little bit more fluid and natural. Okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
But I really like where you are right now, because right now it's kind of that struggle of just your mouth wants to drop the ending sounds and you're saying no more. Okay.
Yeah. Because like my boss here, I bought a house and he said, you own a house, or you own a house. I said, I own a house. He said, what? You own a house or you owe a house?
Own a house. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a really good example. So let's actually stop and do that. I own a house versus I owe a house. So that's the difference of dropping an ending sound and not. So I own a house. I owe a house. So if we don't get that N in there, it totally changes the meaning of it, right?
Yeah, exactly. So I own a house and I owe a house.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that is very, very common. That's why we have to say, okay, no more dropping ending sounds. I'm going to make sure that that's a deliberate effort in my practice. And we're going to retrain. And then once that's more solid and we're getting those ending sounds, then we can start moving and progressing to the next point. But right now it's going to sound really choppy. It's going to sound really choppy because you're trying to get all of those ending sounds on.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So be patient with the process, because it will work. You just have to be patient with this stage of it.
Okay? I appreciate that. But I can you please, because I saw you point out the pasamas, just the driveway to say, or?
Yeah, pajamas.
Pajamas.
Pajamas. So I'm hearing za instead of ja. So it's
pajamas.
The same. There you go. It's just like jump, ja, ja.
Jump. Pajamas.
There it is. Pajamas.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And can you please help me another word? I use it like we had lunch out every day and we go to Subway. And these are the words I usually make it wrong, like avocado, or how
you know, the kind of
avocado,
is that what you mean? Avocado, or we could do dough, avocado.
So the breast will be the third one, right? Avocado.
Yeah, avocado. So third syllable stress, you know, first and third, but third is going to get the primary stress. So avocado.
Yeah.
Okay, but get that O at the end. Avocado.
Avocado.
Mm-hmm. Avocado.
Avocado.
So I'm hearing avocado, and I want that to be a little bit more reduced. Avocado.
Mm-hmm.
Avocado.
Yeah.
You got it. Okay, so those are those real life situations, like being at Subway and saying, I want avocado.
They say, what?
Yeah. Yep, exactly. So those are the kind of words, we call them problem words. It's like, if there is a word that you say that you're like, people aren't understanding me, so I'm probably saying this incorrectly, bring that to the study group, bring that, and we'll work on it, and you can then practice it on your own until you can get it perfect.
Yeah, I very appreciate that. I try to work on like this sometimes, and maybe I will get back with the personal training class, mm-hmm. when I feel a little bit more confident.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, but you're doing really well. You're asking the right questions. You're really identifying in yourself what areas need to be improved. And it's just a matter of just then getting the repetition and practice. So just steady and consistent effort over time makes the biggest difference.